Hey everyone, I know I promised you this review a little sooner, but here it is. We are talking about Fear Street Part 2, 1978. Now, for those of you who don't already know, Netflix has released a trilogy event, a horror trilogy event, within the first three Fridays of July. It's a three-part movie, kind of like Back to the Future, where every installment feels very cohesive, so you gotta watch them back-to-back. When I first saw the advertisements for it, I was like, oh my god, it's gonna be another aimed for the masses of young children, and kids are gonna watch this and be like, oh, okay, it's gonna be very dumbed down, because after seeing the Goosebumps 2015 movie, I was like, come on, you gotta aim it for the adults. And that's what Fear Street is. It is gory, bloody fun, carnage candy. So we picked up where we left off in the first one. The first one kind of felt more of an ode to Scream. This one, Part 2, 1978, feels like an ode to Friday the 13th, and I loved it. It is absolutely brutal because a lot more children, like younger than the teenagers that I talked about in the last one, children actually die in this movie. They get hacked in the face into pieces. Like, I don't know, if you felt uncomfortable watching the new It movies, this might be right up there. It was brutal, but I mean, you can only hack up so many people with an axe that it becomes slightly repetitive. I was hoping to see some kind of iconic, big shocker type kill, like in the first one where the skull face killer put the girl through the meat shredder. But nah, there wasn't really anything like that. I mean, if anything, there was just a lot of, you know, jump scares where he shows up and just, boom, slices him in the face. It's a little more campier and fun this time around, and we get to expand more on the lore and the curse of Sarah Fear, the witch that has plagued the Shadysiders. I also adore our two main leads, who are sisters, played by Sadie Sink and Emily Rudd. They give wonderful performances. Now, Cindy, played by Emily Rudd, was more of a main character for me, but for some reason, she got stuck underground for most of the middle of the movie, which was unfortunate. But if it wasn't for her, we wouldn't have kind of excelled and expanded more on the story of what we were trying to achieve from part one, you know what I mean? I gotta admit, it's a little tough to get into some of the details right now, because some of you guys might be watching this review before you actually see this movie, so I'm gonna leave that up in the air. Ziggy, on the other hand, who's played by Sadie Sink, she has more of the exciting aspect of the whole entire movie, where she's running around from the killer, and it was really more slasher vibe to me than the first one, and I really enjoyed that part. You know, the Thomas Slater stole the show. It didn't need really a lot of the rest of the other killers who popped out last minute at the end to really do anything. It was really more his show, and I really enjoyed that. I'm just gonna take some time to properly absorb this movie before I begin part three. I know it's all streaming now on Netflix, but I'm gonna have to wait. I'm excited, but I'm gonna have to wait. They threw in the trailer at the end credits of part two, and I really find it kind of cool because I'm getting some American Horror Story, Witch Salem type of vibe, because a lot of the actors from part one and two are playing different characters. And it looks pretty cool. I'm excited. Alright, that's all I'm going to discuss with you guys for today, because I just keep gushing about it. So, I'm Jaren. Look forward to more reviews. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Okay, bye.